Hello, everybody. This is Pahimar.
And this is Direwolf20.
And today we bring you episode 9 of Material Energy Hypercubed, Cubed, Cubed.
Yay! Pahimar, I did a lot of things.
And I'm about to place the wool we got from the rotunda.
Oh, sweet. Oh, you're placing it in the little area?
Yeah, in the victory monument.
All right, I have to find out where that is again.
VM. I'm also going to look around in here, because when I was running around in here while we were getting all set up and everything, I noticed that there's, like, reward bags in the chest here. Like, check this one right here.
Where? Oh, look at that. Neat. Basic reward bag. Cool.
So, I'm going to check the rest of the floor, because I feel like, you know, that would be something trolley that Parcel would do.
Sure, yeah. I wouldn't put it past him.
Yep, there's another
reward bags everywhere. Oh, you found another one already?
Yep.
It's a good thing we have that mod that makes it so that you can see inventories, contents, and such.
I think it's pretty much required for this hiding of things everywhere to work.
Ooh, I found one.
Oh, I see. You're trying to steal my bags.
I got a stone round shield.
Nice.
What up?
Got another one.
Got another one.
Wow. Yeah, they're all over the place, aren't they?
Another one.
Really have fun hiding stuff. Speaking of reward bags, I completed a lot of quests between last episode and this one. Mostly just like craft this, manufacture that, put together these items to make this. Like, you know,
cheat in these items.
Yeah, exactly. Cheat in all the things. Where's my flying mechanic? I need something I can fly and run fast with. That's the first thing I would cheat in if I was cheating. But
I got Zeke the Geek's hoe.
So I got Electrum done. That was easy, right? I just needed 10 Electrum ingots, so just silver and gold. We have that. Now that we have access to silver, it was easy to get. So that gets us a block of gold and silver each. I also did silver and lead, obviously. We've got that done. That was easy. Remember you found Vulcanite down in the underground area down there?
Mm-hmm.
So that's a quest that I just completed. You picked it up in block form, so I just converted it to ingots and quest complete. For the win.
Nice.
Nice.
I'm actually going to go up to the observatory so I can drop all this stuff that I'm getting into the AE system.
I wonder when he'll notice this stuff.
What stuff? Who, me?
Nothing.
I didn't notice anything. What are you talking about?
Exactly.
Okay, good. What are you doing to me?
I just think it'll be fun the next time you go to the Victory Monument.
Okay, cool. Dogbarium sword. So we got Dogbarium from some quest we handed in, from the quest that gave us the dog thing.
Simba. So,
yeah. So I turned that ingots that we got into a Dogbarium large sword blade, and that quest should actually be allowing... Oh, I have to pick one reward. I'm thinking... Ooh, cutlass. I don't even know how to make a cutlass, to be honest with you. I'm just going to check, like, what... be the most efficient way to do this.
Well, I picked the cutlass.
Did you? Okay.
Because I figured it's a one-handed weapon.
Well, the Dogbarium block gets you...
Man, you did complete a lot of quests. 1, 2, 3, 4,
I'm telling
five,
you.
Five, six.
7.
Well, I also just handed that one in.
Okay, Queen's Gold was easy to make. It's 8 gold and 1 emerald. In a tinker smeltery. So I had to use one of our emeralds, but I didn't think that was too big of a deal. And it got us, I needed to change that into a large plate. So that gets us some stuff. We have access to a scythe, a battle axe, or 5 large plates, I think is the reward we should go for there, because there's no way that it's going to cost me 5 large plates to make a battle axe, right? No, definitely not. So 5 large plates is the reward to go with. What else do we got here that I completed something or other? There's a way to force completion of a quest, which is, I think, something we should do for that lava fabrication quest.
Oh, okay.
I think you do something... That? I tried and it said I don't have access, so... I figured you just didn't like me.
I don't have it either.
Okay. So... Yeah, you should be opt.
Nope, still don't.
Maybe it's a config file thing? I don't know.
Yeah, possibly. We'll have a look at that.
I also completed wireless lever, which was really easy.
just a single wireless lever.
Yes, which is a block of redstone plus a lever. That got us some P2P tunnels for redstone, so that's kind of nice.
Nice.
And I think that's it. Do I have any more complete? No, there's one more I missed. What else did I do? I did so many quests.
Electrum, silver and lead, and ring of fire.
Oh, I did teleportation. I can use magnetic forces to teleport to anyone around here. The force will be consumed in the process, though. So I had to craft that. They're not. What's that?
How do these things work?
I don't know. Oh, if you right-click them, you can see a person's name, and then I suppose you can choose that person, and it'll teleport you to them. Ooh, look at that. Fancy. That's from random things. Is it taking a while or what?
Hey, there you go. Oh, it just takes a while.
Okay, neat. So they're not actually that hard to craft. We need some of the Ender Fragments from Ender Zoo, which we get from... Usually it's from killing monsters. There's no crafting recipe for them. And then you need Signalium ingots, which you get with melted redstone, copper, and silver. So that was the crafting recipe for that. I think we should hang on to those, because maybe as we're exploring things, what we should do is, like, if we're exploring an area that we really suspect to be dangerous, though it did take a long time for you to teleport to me, but maybe you could, like, pillar up a protective area around you of cobblestone, right? Protect yourself from the monsters, and if there's, like, a ton of monsters around you, you can teleport to me. And then it would be like, Pahimar is now safe.
That could work.
From his own shenanigans.
You have severely picked up on the shenanigans bandwagon from Ori, haven't you?
No, I've kind of always said shenanigans. I got some ender fragments. I've got some redstone alloy ingots. That's cool. I got some more redstone alloy ingots. Go Minecraft randomizer. Quadruple compressed cookie. Ooh, augment space-time flux unifier. Prelate's penance, which is some kind of scythe. And, ooh, I got a view cell. Some storage cells. It's a greater ward. All right. Hey, so our AE system is getting full. So this is good timing.
I'm gonna open my bags. 20 bounce pad.
Nice. There's one thing I've noticed that we haven't gotten access to yet, by the way.
Was it two redstone alloy blocks?
It is not.
What about 50 chains?
Nope.
What about a view cell, 10 1K ME storage cells, and one 4K ME storage cell?
That's what I just got.
Or was it 40 ender fragments? About a redstone charge pad or a redstone health pad?
Nope.
How about six flasks of fire, six flasks of experience, and six flasks of poison?
Nope. None of
those. Okay, then I'm out of ideas.
Yeah. Inscriber presses from AE2, so I have no idea how we can expand our AE network, like have more disk drives and whatnot.
I wonder if that's a topical thing that we'll have to address in the very near future.
I'm questioning that myself. So what do you say I know you wanted to explore some things. So we never really fully explored the first sphere area thingy we got.
And considering all the stuff we just found.
Yeah. Like, right. Now that we know that there's a lot of hidden stuff, I feel like we might want to go explore.
So I'm going to unload.
Okay.
So it should be unloaded now.
Okay. We don't want to forget about the nether sphere, though.
No, we'll go there. Promise? But first, we're going to go back to the inclusion chamber.
I don't know where I'm going. I still want to know what the spatial incubator is all about. Like, why is there a teleport that we can get there with when we can't get there?
I have an idea for that.
Go on.
Well, just because when I was exploring the reflection pools, I saw that the spatial IO room is under this giant iron looking room, which I think is this one here. So I wonder if there's a teleport somewhere inside of here.
That's a possibility. All right,
I'm gonna branch out
my way down here, because I know there's some stuff probably down here, and now I'm way better equipped to handle what crazy monsters might be coming from this area.
I could help you if you weren't blocking the stairs.
I wouldn't be blocking the stairs if it didn't make my life depend on it.
This is just all kinds of fun.
Oh, no, it's a blast. I mean, do you want to come down here? I would not recommend it, but if you want to come, you're more than welcome.
I figured two people would be better than one.
Just stand back and let them explode. Light up, light up. Alright, we should be well lit.
Cool.
Cool. That was scary. So, I mean, it makes sense that there's probably some stuff in here, right? I don't have a shovel with me. Should I probably have one of those?
I have one, actually. I got it in a reward bag, a bone excavator.
Sweet. Oh, an excavator. That's good. And a bone one, even.
And it is slimy, so it'll regen.
Really?
Yep. Same as
my iron.
I don't
think slimy regens.
Oh, it's got auto repair.
Okay, well, as long as it says auto repair, then yeah, it'll repair itself.
I think this is where we were supposed to get the original double compressed stuff, rather than like the deadly miner's age.
That's fine. I've got something that has auto smelt on a shovel. I don't know if I want auto smelt though. I've never.
Oh, that's the nether shovel I got from a reward bag.
Yeah, I'm usually not a fan of auto smelt because
I used it to get the grout.
Yeah, I guess that would be a good thing to get grout with. So did you clear out that area down there already? Oh, there's some coal in there.
Yeah, dense coal. I'm just digging through the stuff. I can give it the shovel first.
I'll clear up the dense coal. Oh, there's a chest. It's got some reward bags in it and some kinds of sword blades. I'll just snag them.
Nice. I saw them briefly.
I'm just going to make sure this area is well lit. I think we're good.
Okay, now there's one thing I've learned. Step back.
Step back.
Okay. Ah!
He likes to hide things
under
things.
I'm itching to repeat what happened in Agrarian Skies. I know it. He's just itching for that to happen again.
Ooh, chest.
Like a hidden chest, or?
Yep.
Yep.
Sweet.
I've, iron war axes, spears, javelins, an iron longbow, and some iron shurikens.
Cool. I got a bloody rose times 64, and I also got 64 holy planks of Scott Killen.
I got a master rod, 4 comparators, and a flint rapier.
Sweet. So this green area should have pretty much nothing going on in it, unless there's hidden stuff. This red area.
I grabbed some ladders because the other thing I learned from him is that he likes to put things on top of things.
Oh. So this red room had some good stuff in it.
What does it have?
I don't know, like redstone related stuff.
Alright, I'm on top of the green room. Oh, there's some stuff on top of the first room there. I see a sign.
Sweet.
Let's have a look. I'm looking for trophies. This is where he loves to hide his trophies. Another chest. Ooh, birch saplings.
Go, Pahimar, go.
Birch is one of the best ones to make a tree farm with.
Is it?
Oh, I see another chest by the look of it. You know,
Pahimar finds all the things.
Well, yeah.
He is really a good treasure hunter, guys.
So you know the spot where you drop down, like, to where all the mobs are and everything?
Kinda, yeah.
So it looks like there's a little platform off the back of it, and there's a chest on it. Oh, it just I just totally ran by a chest on top of the center bit. It's got a ton of potions, cauldrons, Eye of Ender.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, definitely snag those. Skeletons don't waste them.
I actually need to go back, because I don't have enough room.
Yeah, no, that's where I was at, like, 5 minutes ago. I was out of inventory space. I'm gonna try and light the area up in this area as well. Because lighting things up is proving to be a good plan for this map.
I feel like if we had actually, like, really explored this place the first time, we wouldn't have had as hard of a time.
Probably. But he also did get rid of the poor ores thing, so...
True, it is kind of hard to tell where we would be if we had better ores to begin with.
Right. I'm just looking around in this area to see if there's anything hidden. Because he likes to hide things in skystone chests, and this entire area is made out of skystone, which looks exactly like the chest. So it's really hard to find what we're looking for. We finished that Kaliestus thing quest, right? The white one? Yes, but now we need one of each color, which I haven't seen on the map, so I don't know if we need to craft them or what the deal is.
Well, we're looking at two in here. There's green and red.
Well, that's cool.
All right, I'm going to go on top of the red one now. Now, the skystone chest.
Nice.
With 64 colored stone bricks and a sanguinite tool rod.
Nice. I found something weird.
Just take more of a look around.
Well, I found a skystone chest with a bunch of fertilizer in it, some hepatizen dust, a bunch of types of glass, some liquid. Nice.
I've come to the conclusion that he's mostly trolling us.
I think you're 100% correct about that.
All right, let's head up on top of here. Chest. Close enough. Fireball dev. Oh, is this the secret?
What do you mean?
Remember there was a secret quest? But we visited it in the biosphere, so the chest wasn't here. This is the secret.
Oh, really?
It's a chest, and apparently fireballs involved, and it has 64 fireballs in it and 4 flux crystals.
Cool.
I'm just digging out the stone around this thing because I want to just make sure we're not missing anything.
Right, right.
Very funny fireball.
Exploring sort of the area around where the wool chest was, just to see if we didn't miss anything in there.
All right, now
it's kind of hard to explore this area.
Yeah, the more challenging part here is, can I fall down here and not die?
The challenging part for me is inventory management.
That's been your problem since day one.
It kind of has.
Well, yes, I'm totally digging through the side of this room to get up.
Yeah. All right. I don't think there's much else in this.
SGT mace. Auto. It's got a days 15, auto smelting 2. It's a battle axe.
Cool. That sounds neat. Part of my problem at the moment is that I don't have a pick that can really do a good job of digging through skystone.
I just use my steel hammer.
Yeah. I'm trying it with my pick, but I'm pretty sure it's iron based, so not a chance. All right, I think I've at least for the most part explored this area. I mean, there's probably more things I didn't find yet, but...
Oh, these colored stone bricks are what you use to make the lights with an unstable ingot.
Oh, sweet.
You need 8 of them to do it. I found another chest.
Yeah, but we need unstable ingots, which we don't have access to the stuff for that yet. Alright, I'm heading back to the observatory.
Okay, don't reload this place yet.
Okay.
You know, I think we would really benefit from a an energetic infuser.
Probably. Why?
Because we have magnets and stuff, and it would be probably be nice to recharge them.
Oh, I guess. I could work on that if you want.
If it's not too troublesome.
Probably not. Pokefenium, apparently a liquid that I have. It's can be used in a smeltery. It's an alloy of cobalt, iron, and blood. Sweet. And I also got fairy.molten.
So this hidden one had flint shurikens, two good reward bags, a slime longbow, and a copper longbow.
Cool.
Is there anywhere else? Did you go through this place pretty thoroughly?
No. I went through it somewhat thoroughly.
That seems like a you thing to do.
Well, I kind of got bored of going through it so thoroughly.
Well, while I'm here, I'm going to grab this white light. Alright, I'm not seeing any other chests under things. Yeah, Skystone chests are so hard to find in this giant ball of Skystone.
I do not doubt it, sir. I've made an energetic infuser just for you, Pahimar.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Well,
aren't
know.
You just like the just... sweetest candy?
I would not disagree with you on that point.
Alright, I'm gonna go grab a green light.
Okay.
Because... yes. Yep. So the lights in here totally work.
Yeah,
because I have a green one in my inventory. Its reading is 100%, so I'm going to go steal a red one now.
Okay.
Just doing a cursory look around to see if there's any reward bags hidden in here.
All right, the energetic infuser is plugged in and ready to go. And remember, you can upgrade all your tinker's tools with... RF accepting stuff, so if you want to charge them with RF instead of repairing them on a regular basis, that's an option for you.
How do you do that?
You can put like one of the RF batteries, one of the flux capacitors on it as an upgrade.
Oh, cool. Does the thing have to be fully repaired for that to work?
No.
Right,
but you do need sulfur, so you'll have to track that down. I think you can sometimes get it from coal.
So my reward bags, I got 3 nullifiers, 6 terrain smashers, and 2 autonomous activators. And 10 more ender fragments.
I'm actually kind of surprised we don't have sulfur. I've been macerating coal like crazy.
You know where there's probably lots of sulfur?
I don't want to answer that question.
Search your heart. You know it to be true.
It's not true. It's impossible.
Direwolf, we need to go to the nether.
Alright, are you ready for me to unload this thing?
You may unload it, sir.
Alright, I've got one nether sphere ready to load. Spatial IO unloaded. Loaded. All right, buddy. The nether sphere has been loaded up. Whatever happens, I blame you. Oh, goodness. It's already, like, immediately dark right around the opening area.
All right, you keep lighting. I'll keep them off.
Okay. I'm on fire.
Because I lit him on fire.
Because Pahimar.
Oh, my frying pan's broken.
Well, that's not good. No wonder it took you so long to kill him. Where are they coming from? Oh,
they're coming upstairs. I gotta repair this frying pan.
Can you bring a bucket or two of lava with you?
Lava?
Yes. Rapidamente, por favor.
When did you become Spanish?
I don't know. I'm trying to broaden my horizons.
It's like when the zombie showed up.
I'm running. Oh, there's zombies at our doorstep. I don't know how they got there, but I blame you.
Alright, I have lava, and I have some more ineffable glass.
Cool, I snagged some lava as well. Watch out for these dudes.
You take care of the zombies, I'll get this archer.
Okay, deal. He hurts. I should warn you, he's the one I ran from. Alright, watch out, I'm gonna lava it up down there. This should help a little bit.
So first impressions, this place is terrifying.
Yeah, pretty much. Watch out.
So many.
Do you see what I'm doing with lava buckets here?
You're pouring it down to light it up?
Yes. And to kill whatever happens to be down there, hopefully.
I wonder how deep this stuff is.
I have no idea.
Apparently pretty deep.
Oh boy, that's not a good place to be. All right, I'm dead. Zombies snuck up on me.
I apparently am a big fan of the tunnel.
I can see. Let me get some coffee. He blew me up very fast. My stuff's actually not too well guarded at the moment, if you want to help me grab it.
Just a sec.
Okay.
Okay, let's see.
It's just down the stairwell at the bottom. If you can just keep the mobs off me for a minute, I should be able to grab it pretty quick. Just don't break my chest yet, because I want to protect it. There we go. Oh boy. Two creepers snuck up on me that time. I backed away from one and right into another. All right, do you want to take a break for a minute and we'll come back?
Sounds good.
Okay, see you guys in a minute. All right, guys, we're back.
And I'm dead.
Oh, Pahimar, no.
You picked the best time to want to record.
Sorry. Well, the good news is most of this area is lit up now.
Oh, for a second there, you're going to say the good news is that I'm not dead.
Well, yeah, that's... I mean, that's kind of a change from the norm. This area should be reasonably safe. I have Pahimar's head, and I've got three direwolf heads.
I call shenanigans.
He would. What's funny is I'm not getting any magma creams from these little guys I'm killing.
They must have adjusted the drop rate.
Because I've killed at least, 20 of them by now, and no magma creams.
Found a chest of some sort.
Cool. A lot of this area is soul sand of different colors.
Ooh.
So
magmatic florbs, magmatic dynamos, and lava generators.
That's cool. I found an Enderman. Should I take him on?
I think we all know how well that goes for you.
It typically goes very well.
This excavator is awesome for the soul sand.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Sand counts as dirt. I'm going to try and kill this Enderman. Oh, that's right. My sword has the fire aspect on it. That's one of the main reasons I don't like to have a sword with fire on it. Like, it's great for killing everything but Enderman, because they just teleport the minute you hit them. Alright, so underneath the area that we're currently in looks a little bit even more scary than the area that we're currently in.
Of course. I mean, because, like, why not?
Well, I think that's kind of the point, but... And I'm not surprised. I'm just like, aw.
You're just disappointed?
I'm now an expert at using the longsword that I have, and it just gave me a new modifier. I think I'm actually to the point where I need to repair it. I should do that before we go explore down there. Alright, so this first tier is lit up pretty well.
Yep, I'm just digging out a bit under here, wondering if there's more secrets and stuff.
Alright, I'm gonna go home and repair my sword. Do you want to come back in a minute?
Sure, I'm just digging, so...
My plan kind of is to dig underneath the current lava source blocks that we have down there, and then we can just let that lava flow down to the next tier.
Oh, that makes sense.
Right?
Right.
Alright, back in a minute, guys. Alright, Pahimar, check out what I'm doing down here.
You are making nice collars for the lava.
Yeah. And I'm also digging out the block underneath them so that the lava flows down underground. Kind of like that.
I'm trying to find out why these magmas still spawning.
There is literally a skeleton climbing up the lava, and it is a wither skeleton with an arrow. Pahimar, help.
You brought this on yourself?
I did.
Yeah, you killed it.
Yeah, thanks for your help.
I was right behind you, buddy.
You were right behind the skeleton. I survived with two hearts left. I'm proud of that. Got a lot of arrows. I figured out where ectoplasm comes from.
Where's that come from?
Ectoplasm comes from randomly when you kill monsters, a little blue, like, it looks almost like a slime, but like it's really small and blue and it flies, will appear, and if you kill that, you get ectoplasm. So now I know. And I think there's a quest or two I can use to do something about that. But anyway, I think we have to wrap up right now, Pahimar, and come back next episode and explore further into the Nether Sphere.
Yeah, I could probably stand regrouping.
Okay, that's probably not a bad idea. So did you find anything good down here while you went exploring, or?
Just that chest of stuff. I haven't found anything else yet, but I haven't explored much else either. I'm just now going to move some more of this. As we progress further into this place, I'm going to reclaim the glass we used before.
So I did get one magma cream just now.
I got one too. I had to kill a big one.
Yeah, we've killed a lot of them, so I'm guessing that looting has been changed there, because usually you get more magma cream than that. But anyway, we'll be back next time. We'll explore the Nether Sphere some more, and hopefully manage to accomplish a few more quests.
Yay!
All right, guys, Direwolf20 and Pahimar signing off. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Take it easy.
Bye!